I'm Oscar. When it comes to treasures of the Pacific, you can't go past the humble ukulele. The very sound of this instrument is synonymous with this part of the world. Now, of course, places like Hawai'i, the Cook Islands, Tahiti have a very strong tradition, and I'm very happy to learn that it's making a return here to Samoa. Let's hit the road. In order to look further into this story, our travels are taking us to the village of Poutasi in Falealili. Funnily enough, where my mum grew up. And there's the sign. Our destination today is the Poutasi Art Centre to see this man, Tuatanga Lord Joe Annandale, ukulele enthusiast and big chief in the village. What's your earliest memory of hearing, do you know in terms of the history of how this instrument arrived in Samoa? Because we associate Hawai'i when we think of this instrument. Do you know when it made the skip over here?
I can recall back in those plantation days, there were ukuleles then. And in my time, of course, I had members of my family who were great musicians. And they played both guitar and ukulele.
And you fell in love with it straight away?
Absolutely.
The ukulele has an interesting history. Its home is not Hawai'i, like most people think, but Madeira, a little place off the coast of Morocco. In the late 1880s, Portuguese immigrants took the stringed instrument to Hawai'i. Back then it was called a machete, and later, the ukulele, which literally means jumping flea. From Hawai'i, it was a small jump to reach other parts of the Pacific, including Samoa, Tonga, and Fiji. Was it always your dream that you would have a factory here where you could produce the ukulele in Samoa? Or how did that come about?
I got to meet some ukulele makers back in New Zealand, and John Hewitt comes to mind, because John was one of the instigators of the very first ukulele festival that was held back in 2007 in New Zealand.
Wow.
And of course I came back to Samoa and I thought, well gosh, if festivals like that can be held in New Zealand, why can't it be done here? I took it up as a project. When I was asked on one interview that I did here in Poutasi after the tsunami as to what I would like to see happen in this community, I said, you know, I'd like to teach my people here, the young folks, how to play ukulele. And then this, of course, got shown in New Zealand, and so there was a lot of interest, and I got a call from ladies who teach guitar and ukulele in New Zealand, and they asked if I would be interested in them coming up to help start this ukulele school. And I said, of course. So they came and stayed here with us in the village, and they started school, and I've carried on with that.
Has it extended beyond Falealili? Has the interest?
Well, to be I'm a little embarrassed, because you know, when the news got out there that we were making ukuleles and that I was teaching kids, I've been inundated with requests from people on the other side of the island to come and teach ukulele. There's a lot of interest, really. In the meantime, my friend John Hewitt, who did have the factory in New Zealand, rang me and he says, Joe, I'm closing the factory, I'm getting too old. And would you be interested in buying my equipment? He had to admit that some of his equipment was a bit old and they really needed to be replaced with new stuff. And then, of course, we had to have somebody to make it. So the next option was for us to send somebody from here to train. And we did that. He trained under John Hewitt, and as you see,
and is that this, one of this ones is one he of the, made?
Yes, this one here. That's it.
Wow. Yeah.
It's a six.
I
feel like I want to hear you play this.
You reckon?
Yeah, you up for that? This is like having Jimmy's Fender Stratocaster, but it's Kawaka's.
Well, you're a Falealili man. Why don't we sing a Falealili song?
I'll just hum along.
And so that's what we've done. Sat on the deck watching the sea roll in, the cool breeze cutting above Joe's dulcet tones, all the while reminiscing about when the ukulele brought comfort to plantation workers around the islands.
So there you have it. Something very special is building here in this beautiful southeast corner of Samoa. And it's not just ukuleles, of course. There's crafts, there's paintings, there's coffee, and there's stick figures. So if you want to check them out, Poutasi Art Centre. Wow, that was quite exciting. I haven't yet graduated to playing one, but I think I'll practice on this because who knows, in the future, Samoan Ukulele Orchestra. Oh, I can hear it now.
I saw your love left it to be yala. Eonga for ita angata my masani letu kulanga fa amane ene.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.